Hello, good afternoon. This is a workshop of the programming quantum computer. I am Prapas Chongthitit Vatthana from Faculty of Engineering, Chulalongkorn University. I will first give you a basic of the quantum computer. This presentation will be for about half an hour and maybe a bit more. Then I show you some quite interesting short video on the actual quantum computer from IBM system. And afterward, you can get your hands on trying, or we will show you how to program this kind of machine. So let's start. Okay, this is the outline of this short introduction. First, we will explain what the quantum computer and how it works. Later on, and you can have the hands-on experiment, okay? That we will try a very simple programming to get a feel how that really work based on some quantum computer simulator that is publicly available. For this video and more information on quantum computing, please visit my homepage. There's a lot more information on that. I will show you this QR code again at the end of presentation. Okay, let's begin with what is the quantum computer, right? Quantum computer, we will contrast it with the classical or present day computer. The quantum computer is based on just a special property of the memory. Okay, we call that memory a quantum bit. The classic computer called the smallest unit of information that it can store as a bit, okay? And using this special memory, which is totally different from classic computer, that we can use a massively parallel operation, okay? Which make quantum computer very, very fast. So let's explain about this special memory a little bit more. Let's contrast it with the classic computer bit. Classic computer bit, one unit can store either one or zero. Okay, so which one set and another set. Okay, so the quantum bit is can store both. Okay, it's a kind of a probabilistic device based on the quantum effect, right? That we can represent state. Therefore, one unit of the quantum bit can store both zero and one at the same time. So this is a magical property. And also when two quantum bits are in proximity, it can induce kind of entanglement. We are not going to commit which kind of physical device can have this property, but we use this property in quantum computer, okay? And with entanglement, affecting of one qubit, okay, the probability, changing the property of one qubit will have effect with the other qubit that is in entanglement with this bit. So this is a kind of what do you call? Because of this, we can do lots of very strange and beautiful operation on this kind of memory. Okay. I will introduce a bit of mathematical notation, right? Because it is based on a quantum effect, therefore we use the quantum physics notation of ket, Therefore, the state of the quantum bit, okay, is the part of ket zero and part of ket one, and the coefficient, of course, we normalize it to be the amplitude of one, okay, and one of the most popular presentation is a kind of sphere, okay, we call it Bose sphere based on the researcher who invented this notation, and you can think of the quantum state as a point on the surface of this unit sphere. Okay, if you can measure this sphere using coordinate, okay, a kind of angle, we use this kind of angle in performing operation on the memory. Okay, all right. And what is the advantage of this kind of memory? It is very fast compared to conventional computer. Okay, therefore this is the promising. Okay, of course theoretically we can imagine what we can do with it. At the present time, we are trying to engineer the device that can then do a few operation. Okay, and also because of the quantum bit have probabilistic property. Okay, so it actually very large compared to the unit of bit. Let's compare two classic bits. Okay, two classic bits can store 00 or 0110 and 11. Therefore, it's contained two bit can store and can represent four kind of thing. But at one time, it can represent just one thing in four. Right? But because of the quantum bit, it can a probabilistic of all kinds of four pattern at once. Therefore, it can represent up to 2 to the 2. Right? So it exponentially can store more things than classic bit. So you can imagine that the memory is very, very condensed, or it can represent a very large number of objects. We have yet to really make use of this property, but first impression is that it's very fast. Okay, in theory, okay, in practice, it depends on how we engineer or how we build the machine. The machine can be built. The quantum bit can be built with many technology. The first picture I show you is using light, okay, using photon, okay, the kind of shining the laser light through mirror. And that sort of thing. And the state of quantum bit can be regarded as using what they call polarization of the light. Okay. Using light at the moment is require space because we have to shine the light. We also can build the smaller, but not very small, not as small as microelectronic yet, okay? But light have a very good property, okay? And become one of the more popular one for researcher, okay? The, say the that kind of qubit or operation on qubit can be represented by a kind of quantum circuit. This kind we can call quantum gate. Okay, this is one of the notation for a control swap. Okay, so information can exchange between two lines. Okay, this line represent a kind of quantum storage. Okay, so you can think of that is a quantum bit hanging on this line. Okay, and the right hand side may be the notation of the optical arrangement. Okay. I use this very old table to show you there are many technology to build quantum bit. Let's say nuclear spin, electron spin, ion trap, and I show you ion trap. We have one experiment in Thailand. Okay, and quantum dot, okay, right? And optical cavity or microwave. They're one of the property of the quantum state. It's very fragile. It's very short. The life span is quite short. 10 to the minus 2, right? 1 to 100, okay, of a second, right? And some of them, ion trap is okay, 1/10. Okay. Information can have a, right? Okay, this kind of a time duration, and then it just disappear because of the what call it, nature of the state. Okay, not very stable. Photon is better because when it's entangled, it can live quite long. Okay. All right. Some of them are very short, right? Using gallium arsenide, for example, is 10 to the power of 10, but very, very short. 1 in 1,000 million second. Okay. There are many experiments. I show you the experimental picture of these kind of device to build quantum so-called quantum gate, okay, from a quantum bit, okay. So this one, okay, right, look like the slot, right? Okay, and it have to be contained in the chamber, and a lot of this kind of manipulating the atom, okay, because we can use the single atom to represent a quantum bit, right? And so most of these device will be operate under almost absolute zero temperature, very, very low, 50 millikelvin, for example, that kind of thing. So this sort of device have to be immersed in a very cold storage. Okay, then some of them can fabricate into a kind using a microelectronics, okay? Look like a microchip, right? This is a few qubit. I give you two examples of the well-known, very stable machine, right? One of the IBM, and today we will use the IBM facility to explain on experiment with the programming, the quantum computer, right? And also another one is the older one, maybe the first commercially available machine, D-Wave, okay. D-Wave is a special machine, not general purpose machine, okay, because we can call it quantum annealing, but because it can do just a class of operation, not all kind of operation. Okay. Recently, not recently, but in 2015, before the Google introduced it, quantum AI lab, it published this experiment and claim using the D-Wave machine, right, doing some small optimization on a large number of variables, and they claim that measure on the actual machine can 100 million times speed up compared to a normal, let's say, Intel processor, modern processor machine, okay. 100 million times. Yeah, that's very, very, very fast. But just for a single kind of optimization, okay. And the machine that's built especially for wiring, especially for this problem, okay. Just an experiment, but it generate a lot of interest in this field. Okay, this is the paper that I this is before it had been reviewed and published. I think I got it from ASIF, okay, in 2015. All right. Now I think this team now has been replaced by more engineering to do actual machine. Another view that for the optical kind of quantum computer is a kind of optical workbench. A lot of, I think this one is in Germany, right? Maybe doing some small operation on a quantum bit. Okay, not. I think the whole arrangement is compute very not very big problem. Right. Just to show you that the optical setup is very large, require a lot of space, and we can really use it as a general purpose machine right now. Okay, so this is one of the available machine for today, and the most well known is like IBM. No bias, because they are the only one who make this system available for fabric, for education. Okay, other people can make available for the commercial partner. Okay, but then and also IBM has been doing the research on quantum computing. Okay, they try to build this kind of machine since 40 years ago. Yeah, right? when I just enter the field, right? I read about them. So yeah, they have long history on with this machine, and right now they promote their effort a lot, and they install some system. The video at the end of this presentation will show you the actual system installed in Japan. Okay, one of the first so-called first generation. Okay, this one I think is currently they have a 50 qubit. If you think of in terms of classical computer, 50 bit is too small, but 50 qubit is exponentially storing more information than 50 bit. Okay, we estimate that maybe we need about 1,000. Okay, what we call good quality. Right now we don't have it yet. Okay, good quality qubit to be making some useful application in industry. Okay, that perhaps that we arrive in 10 or 20 years. Okay, IBM have a 10-year plan, but of course of the commercial enterprise have to be optimistic, but otherwise they cannot really invest, right? But I will be more careful about being optimistic. I'm optimistic about the field, but not about the actual machine that can work reliably. Okay, so this is more core computing, the vertical cylinder, and the rest is a kind of you can see it's mostly a cooling device. It works under 50 millikelvin, so this is near absolute zero. Okay, you have to be cool somehow. And inside the cylinder is a kind of the weird looking circuit, mostly composed connection, maybe a gold and something, because it have to a normal metal is very brittle at the near zero, right? And IBM device based on superconducting. Okay, so a kind of resonance circuit. In this picture, which get it from IBM, they available publicly, and the actual quantum bit, okay, is in the square here. So five square is here, so it's a five qubit, and the rest is just a kind of signal wiring to measure and to buy a circuit and other thing. You can see the actual T type, right? On the tip of this T is a kind of resonance circuit, modeling in terms of resistor and what we call inductor, right? So you can activate it. It's bit say for this kind of circuit, it activated microwave. Okay, so it can change the level of energy. Okay, right, and by the being proximate, right, they probably have they can do an entanglement. Okay, because they are near each other. And that the IBM based on superconducting, And this one is the one Google used to do the earliest experiment. Now the Google also produced its own quantum computer based on superconducting device. Superconducting device is quite promising because it can be fabricated using the current microelectronics facility, right? You can build very small, like you have seen that the 5 qubit, and we can build more of them and wire together. But there are a lot of difficulty because everything has to be worked under a very, very low temperature. And the state of quantum is very fragile. So D-Wave is built with the same principle, but they're wiring and they're activating the quantum bit in a different way, right? So more limited way, but they can build a lot of quantum bit. I think the current state of the machine, they have to 2000 quantum bit, but we call those quantum bit or the current quantum bit as a noisy. Okay, we will talk about that a bit later. Okay, next step, it is we know probably a little bit about quantum computer now. But we want to program it, okay, because that's the main aim of the workshop today. So let's define that what kind of quantum computer is a kind of programming that work on quantum computer. Okay, I give it very, very broad way. We're probably not talking about language yet. Okay, just like the classic computer in the early days, right? Maybe it's hardwired, maybe it's just using a what I call punch card, right? Whether they have language or not language, or machine code, right? That is not really very important right now for the state of the art of quantum computer. So let's talk about this algorithmic steps, okay, a recipe to operate on the quantum bit, okay. And the famous algorithm, which ignite all the interest or the worry, okay, about quantum computer is this one, because Professor Chou has shown a theoretical paper. Okay, he's not building any circuit. Okay, it just show the step of operation of quantum bit that can factor a large number. Okay, right. So we call this integer factorization. The define as given an integer, right? I find the prime factor. So let's say 3 multiply 5 equal 15. So given 15, then find 3, find the prime factor. Okay. Why is it important? I show you the picture of Professor Chou in 1994, when he published this paper. Because this is important. Or exciting or worrying, because our security, let's say automatic teller machine, for example, is based on exactly the difficulty of doing integer factorization. Yeah, if you try to do that on the classic computer, it takes long time. Okay, but for quantum computer, it's just much faster. It doesn't mean that now we can crack it, because quantum computer is still a kind of experiment, okay? And we're very small, very small. Let's imagine we have a 4-bit computer, okay? Yeah, so it is not really can tackle the actual security code yet, okay? However, in theory, quantum computer can crack this code very fast. So currently, we have the research on the post-quantum security. Okay, so a lot of very, very smart people are working on that. I think the result is coming out every month. So in the next 5 years, we will have a new kind of encryption or cryptographic based on post-quantum, okay? I have my previous two students working a PhD in two continents working on this kind of problem. So it's a lot of people, a lot of smart people are working on that. All right, so this is an example of the abstraction that we can represent a quantum program on quantum computer, right? This is a kind of lowest level, the abstraction that we have the quantum circuit, okay? And then we compose them. And the line, this line, is a kind of quantum state. So therefore, it's a quantum bit hanging on each line. And then the square box is a kind of operation. Let's say your actual device, if this is a quantum bit, then if this is a superconducting device, right? Then we can make operation by beaming, sequence of beaming the microwave to activate we call the twist the state, right? Or we can change the angle if we represent the state of quantum based on Bose sphere, the point on a ball, okay, on the surface of a ball. Okay. We can twist and change it by twisting the angle. This is a mathematical representation, okay? So the actual physical is for superconducting is to just change it. And if we use the light, the photon, then we twist the polarization, that sort of thing. Okay. So this is kind of circuit, right? And then we have some kind of measurement. Once we want, you can wire a lot of circuit here. So the step or the quantum volume is many bit and many step. Okay, so right, the quantum bit is okay, and then operation. Then finally, this is a quantum state, right? So we measure it and the quantum state disappear. We can measure it at the end of computation. Okay, so it's one round, right? So that's, you can imagine the quantum program like this. And to make it clear, right, then yeah, it's an A, B, C, D is a four program. For such a very small and trivial operation, we compose of so many basic circuit. This notation like H, like a Hadamard gate, has been defined and agreed upon by the researcher for throughout these last 10 years. So it became a first version of operation that represent quantum computing, okay, operation, right? We also talking, I show you some concrete example of a quantum program in kind of a pseudocode, okay, which I make a research with some of my former student. Now he's in Sweden, I think. In 2012, right, that we implement the one very generic optimization algorithm on quantum computer. At that time, we don't have any machine, so we run it on simulation, okay? You can find a reference of this paper at the end of this presentation. Okay, for optimization, we kind of randomly generate two vector or two solution and then measure the goodness of that. And then we try to generate another candidate based on the, to be nearer to the winner of these two. So when we're talking about quantum, right, this is just using quantum computer to run this kind of optimization based on a classical idea of the genetic algorithm. Okay, a special version called compact genetic algorithm. So the red line run on the quantum circuit. Okay, initialize the quantum bit, or we call Q register, okay? And then, yeah, we can sampling, right? We can twist it, and then it's still in quantum state. It contains so many solution at the same time, not one, right? And then we measure that, and yeah, we do one, and then this black is run on classic computer, because we can't do anything on quantum computer for this kind of thing. So we measure and when we measure the fitness of the two sample that come out from quantum circuit, random, okay, and then we update this. It had to be mixed between classic, had to be setting the operation, the coefficient of the operation, and then regenerate one and two again. So it go repeat until the one we sampling, the solution that come from quantum circuit is near to or have the objective function value as good as we want. Okay. So you can immediately recognize that, hey, it is not purely quantum. Yeah, it is not really purely quantum. So it's not very fast, because the red line run by quantum circuit, the black line run by classical computer, and we have to repeat this so many times, right? Because it is the whole quantum circuit is you call it probabilistic. So when you set up and then you measure, you got one answer, right? The second setup maybe initial is the same, quantum is the same, and you measure again, it will not, most likely not be the same answer. So how to find the answer? You run it a few times, we call a few shot. Okay, a slang we use in programming quantum computer. And then you correlate the solution. Yeah. Maybe you want to say measure 2 + 3 is 5, sometimes it's 4, sometimes it's 6. But it appears 5 more often than 2 or 3, then we believe that we believe most likely that the answer is 5. Okay, that kind of, so you have to run a few shots. How many shots? Well, that remain to be analyzed, depend on the kind of your quantum circuit. So it's a kind of setting up circuit, run it through, right? And if you do some optimization, you have to have the classical computer at the end, and then readjust the coefficient in your circuit and run it again, and go through this hybrid, yeah, quantum classic, quantum classic, a few times until you did it for solving optimization problem. Wow, I'm almost run half an hour already. And also in that year, a year later, we trying to make this loop faster, right? So let's concentrate on why we can have the quantum speed up, right? That the previous pseudocode or algorithm run just exactly like a classic. It just give you answer of faster or slower, depend on a lot of things, right? But it does not have any real advantage, just that I can I can run classic problem on quantum computer. And it take us another year to really think of this improvement on the third line, because the quantum circuit or quantum memory have this special, is possible, right? Remember, we generate 2, okay? Now, both of that has come out with random, okay? But now we say, hey, we want the second to be better than the first. Yeah, it can be done in one step. Very, 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 very strange. It took us a year to be able to come up with this idea. So with this third line, right, then the optimizer will always be improved. So it arrives at the solution much faster, exponentially faster than the first circuit. Okay. Currently, we are doing a more kind of elaborate with with the, because there were those 10 years ago research, 2012, right? And today is 2022. So last year, my doctoral student who will give you a tuition, okay, on programming later on, coming up with this more elaborate and more complex, right, solution of composing quantum circuit to solve Turing Salesman problem. Okay, we're not going into detail. You can read it if you want. I give the reference at the end of this presentation. Okay, but the circuit is the first. It is solving very small problem, because even though we run on the simulation, and it takes a lot of resources. So the largest problem is initially we run just three city, but three city is too small. You can actually solve it by virtually just looking at the problem, right? But then it requires qubit, and not just for three city, we need 4 qubit, and 4 city we need 8 qubit, and 5 city we need even more. So I think the largest simulation we can run maybe about 10 qubit. So the machine that we can really, and IBM provide big machine to run, but not for the public use. Okay, and so I'm talking about public use. So this kind of circuit composer, and then we are talking about rotating or generating the by moving the angle, right? So all this violet box actually twisting or changing the state slightly of each qubit. Okay, so this is just part of the circuit that we do. We build quite big one. It take quite a few hours to run. Besides the machine from the West, then in Thailand we also have. I visit them just before the COVID broke out, right? In I think December 2019, I have visit them at the Center of Excellence in Physics at University of Chiang Mai, and they set up this optical workbench to isolate a single atom. Which if we can isolate a single atom, then we can adjust it. We can manipulate it. Energy level, okay, and also entangle two atom together, right? So we also have this experiment running on, all right. And lastly, I show you the first commercially available machine, not the first, but the first from IBM, maybe, right? They call the System 1, okay. They are talking about System 2 right now. And System 1, I think they upgrade, they have two machines installed in Japan, right? And later on, after this presentation, we show you the maybe short 2-minute video from IBM on assemble of that machine. The IBM have collaboration with Tokyo University and Industrial Park, and they install one of their machine. The other one is, I think, UVLKO or maybe, right? And I think at that time, it's 27 qubit. Maybe they are already upgraded this year into 50 qubit. I'm not quite sure. But those short video, we show you how this very sexy looking or strangely looking machine being assembled. So you get the idea of complexity of this machine. Of course, we know in the core, it's just kind of circuit, right? And not many units at that, right? This machine initially is just 20 or 30 qubit, that's very complex engineering process. You can also remember this, get this PowerPoint, and then use this link to look at that original video yourself. I give you a reference of the my research there, and I point you to the last reference. which is quite good. If you want to know that what is the impact on the industry, right? We have this company McKinsey, right? Already written about that and then published a publicly available. You can just search the name like this, and you got it free download from the internet just the end of last year. I highly recommend. So you know the forecasting, what kind of the advantage, how long it should be, and so on. It's probably in 2030, right, that we will have a general purpose quantum computer machine. And lastly, I would like to thank my research on quantum computing. It's based on large group of students. It is taking this just before COVID, right? And by the end of this year, we probably have the gathering of the new batch of students. I think more than half of them already graduated and become lecturer or working industry, right? Thanks a lot for attending this workshop. And more information, you can just take the photo of this quote and then visit my website. Thanks, and hope you enjoy the afternoon session on hands-on, or if you don't have a machine, you can just follow what the tutor show you on the screen. Bye-bye for now. Please try your hands-on programming quantum computer. Good luck and keep safe.